Hello, friends. Happy New Year. 2016. Wasn't it just 1974 a moment ago? Geez. Anyway, welcome to my vlog. Vlog disclaimer, if you think that posting personal medical information on social media is tacky, offensive, inappropriate, or all three? You're probably right, but don't get all judgy, okay? It works for me. It works for me. Actually, this works a lot better than writing it. I'm not that... Reading and writing is taxing, and so I've been talking all my life, so I can do that. I'm not sure what I'm going to call this vlog. Crazy Sexy Cancer and Cancer Schmancer have already been taken, so I'll have to cogitate upon that one for a while. But this is my cancer vlog. I have acute lymphoblastic leukemia, which is in remission, and I have chronic lymphocytic leukemia currently. On the 18th, I had a bone marrow biopsy. And by the way, that old wives' tale or the astute observation of operating room nurses appears to be true. Redheads have a high tolerance for sedation. How do I know this? Because I felt the bone marrow biopsy as the doctor started. I did let him know, so he backed off and gave me some more of those wonderful sedative drugs he has. So the results are, my CAT scan shows there's no significant increase in the masses. Yay! There is a significant increase in the size of my spleen, and I've intuited this for a while. I'd be, you know, just do-de-do-de-do, going about my day, and I would get like, you know when you've run too much and you get a stitch in your side? I'd get one high in my ribs, and I'd cry out, and Michael would say, "Boo, what's wrong?" And I'd go, "I think my spleen's enlarged." Nailed it. Okay, so my spleen is enlarged, and the bone marrow results weren't so great. Let me tell you that. They weren't so great. Apparently, 87% of the cell is full of cancer cells, and 13% is comprised of normal cells. Yeah. So my leukemia is stage 4 and chemo starts next week. I see the pharmacist on Monday, I guess, to he will explain to me what this cocktail of drugs is going to do. But actually, it sounds manageable. I have one day of Rituxan, and those of you with so-called MS, you know what I mean, you might recognize this because it has, the generic name is something something MAB, which, like, it's similar to Tysabri. In fact, Rituxan is used on MS patients. It has a monoclonal antibody on it, which, well, I won't go into that. So there you have it. The other drug in this little mix, on day 1, I get Rituxan. Day 2, I get Rituxan and bendamustine, which is mustard gas, kind of like a nerve gas. So it's organic. It's not a little designer, you know, add a cell here, put a molecule of that there. So it's old school. And I'm okay with it. I'm actually okay with the whole thing. I have no idea why. I think there might have been damage to my vagus nerve and all these, you know, illnesses that have overtaken this bag of protoplasm I inhabit. And my vagus nerve has definitely, I do have dysfunction in my vagus nerve, and I feel emotions differently. I don't have fear. I used to be very fearful, high anxiety. And I don't have fear about it. I mean, I'm not taking credit for it because it's nothing I did personally, but my life has gotten very different. I've been very secluded. I've spent long hours by myself. You know, when Michael gets home, he will be the first human I've talked to during the day. Yeah, I talk to the animals all the time. I kind of like the seclusion. I've spent a lot of time with myself, and I'm getting to know me. Being alone was one of my least favorite things to do, and now it's welcomed. Although, I've had enough alone time. If you guys want to come visit me, I am getting a bit lonely from my friends. You know, I don't see you all very much. I know it looks like I'm out and about all the time, but if you take a closer look at some of my pictures and postings, I only leave the house to leave town. When I'm home, I'm in the house all the time. So, peaceful. And, you know, there's an upside to everything. I don't read anymore because it's so taxing. You know what I do? I listen to podcasts. If this had never happened, I would have never discovered podcasts. I remember the first time I heard that word, I couldn't quite imagine. I had no idea. I thought of somebody sitting in a little podcasting. I didn't know what it was. So I started listening to podcasts. The radio shows. Why don't they just call them radio shows? I don't know. I thoroughly enjoy that. And so if you have a favorite podcast, would you let me know, please? And I did post my resolutions for the year 2016. And I'm adding one to that. And that is to reach out to my friends, most of whom haven't really understood that I'm not really out and about running. People say, oh, you just seem so busy. Busy? Busy? Well, I do keep myself busy, but it's like taking care of myself takes all day, you know? So I'm not really busy. I'm always putzing around. That's what my dad would say. What are you doing, Dad? Oh, just putzing around. I putzy around, I take care of my yard, I take care of my man, I take care of my house, I take care of my animals. So that's a full-time job. I'm sending out lots of love to you all. Your post to me means so much to me. And I get kind of freaked out because I don't respond. I'm always waiting. I think, oh, I'm going to respond when I have clarity of thought and when I can just put into words what they mean to me. And that doesn't happen. So, vlog one of my new vlog detailing the fascinating in and outs of leukemia. I don't know how fascinating that is. Actually, leukemia is kind of boring. Although I never get bored. That is one emotion I just don't have. I just, there's too many interesting things for me to get bored. I have limited energy, plus I don't have any platelets or, the capacity to fight infection, so I stay in a lot. A lot of sick people out there in that world. So there's lots of things that I can do just from the comfort of my home. I'm not on the phone much at all. I do appreciate phone calls, but that means I have to know where my phone is or to remember to plug it in or blah, 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 blah. Memory is a terrible thing to lose. Do come see me, call me, pray for me. I would appreciate that. I can't leave this earth yet. Michael would be a mess. I don't think that man would be able to take care of himself, and he is losing his vision. So I gotta watch out for the guy. So I'll be around. So call me. No, I won't pick up the phone. Post me. No, I can't read that well. Come by and see me. I'm here. If you're at in Seattle, you're near Children's Hospital, University Village, the University of Washington, Magnuson Park. Hey, the dog park at Magnuson, Matthews Beach. Those are all very, very close to where I live. So come see me. Just give me a heads up, so I can put on some deodorant or something. And nah, don't even need to give me a heads up. I'm wishing you all a peaceful, I was gonna say productive, but for some people that's not really what they're looking for. I wish you a year that brings you all that is good for you. Love you all. Peace. Bye-bye.